I've heard about your plant-based eggs several years ago when Bill Gates started to get excited about it. So tell me, how did you get Walmart involved in this?
Well, it's really about trying to figure out a way for regular people to eat better. You know, Walmart's philosophy is save money, live better. And for us, it's about looking at all the plants around the world, picking the best of them, and then using it to see if we can make food, whether mayo or cookies, that not only tastes delicious, but is also more sustainable, and most importantly, more affordable. And we live in a world today where we're usually the thing that is not so good for the body and not so good for the planet tends to be delicious and tends to be affordable.
Right.
We like to do the opposite, and it gets the folks at Walmart pretty excited about it.
Well, I can imagine, so a product like yours where you're using essentially plant-based materials and you're creating food, essentially eggs that taste just like eggs, you know, you can scramble up your eggs like you would a real egg. I can imagine to like a Whole Food customer, that would be very appealing, but how do you make that appealing to a Walmart customer?
So think of someone like my dad, who is probably the quintessential Walmart customer. My dad, his goals when he goes into a grocery store, he wants really delicious, really affordable food. And just imagine he's going down all the aisles. He's going down aisle 7. Let's say it's the mayonnaise aisle. Mm-hmm. His goal, again, is he wants a delicious mayo that's affordable. And if we can make a mayonnaise, just a simple food product, that is less expensive than the status quo, that tastes better than the status quo, and oh, by the way, if he cares, is a bit better for the body and certainly better for the planet, guess what? My dad will buy it every single time because his drive is affordability and taste.
So,
and that's what our drive as a company is.
Okay, so like let's say Kraft Mayo, then how are you price point wise compared to them?
So roughly we're about 10 to 15% less expensive than the top brands out there, Kraft, Hellman's. And that's really our philosophy as a company. We don't think change comes from just being a little bit more pricey and maybe tasting the same as the status quo. Change happens when you make the good thing so fundamentally better that even people like my dad, who were just trying to get on and live their lives, end up choosing the right thing just because it's better. And that's how we think we change things.
Better and it tastes good. And hey, if it's cheaper, that's great. Josh, just on a final note, you're in your third series of funding right now. Tell me, who are you getting, who is your lead investor at this point, and who are you getting funds from?
Yeah, so we're talking to lots of people. Our lead investor from Series B is Mr. Li Kai-shing, the wealthiest person in Asia, and his firm Horizons. This time around, we're fortunate enough to be talking to everyone, investors all across East Asia and South Asia and some of the typical firms in Silicon Valley. So we're in the process of really putting it together. But I think there's a common theme in food is this big problem, but a big opportunity to hopefully make things a little bit better for people. And it's time to do it fast. And we think we're doing that.
All right, Josh, thank you so much. Not bad to have Li Kai-shing at your back. Josh Tetrick, the founder and CEO of Hampton Creek Foods.